Yeah. Okay. Welcome to the Bacchanal Podcast. It's your boy Akil with
K to the C, man. We got a special guest.
She ain't that special. She's just been on a hiatus for a minute.
I haven't been on a hiatus. It is so sick, bitches.
Speaking about sick, this is the Ronna episode, that Ronna. Now, if this is your first time listening to the Bacchanal Podcast, your number one spot for hip-hop, video games, comic news, but, you know, since everything's shut down, we're going to be talking about the coronavirus, and then we're going to do a retro review of Candyman, since Candyman's been on a lot of people's mind. So, let's start the episode off with what's everybody's been up to, and, you know, what's going on in your neck of the woods, because I know I got a ton of corona stories to tell.
From my so sick. So sick, how you been?
Well, so sick's been sick for the past 2 weeks. I can't even cough for this motherfucker with all these bitches trying to quarantine my ass. Listen, bro. I swear to God, one of these sousas in the office was going to friggin' bust me in the head. I had to friggin' run. You guys, I've been sick, coughing, because I have allergies every season. Every single person that I walk past, I have to tell, no, it's just allergies, y'all. I had to show proof. Like, it's just allergies. Look, my nose is running, okay? When you have the Rona, your nose is dry. My nose is running, okay?
I got Rona in my throat. I'm one of those type of people where I always think I got something. So me being asthmatic and having irritable bowel syndrome, I'm like, oh, shit, nigga. I can't breathe and I've been shitting. I must have got the Rona. So I went to Trader Joe's, my stomach growling. I fucked around and sneezed real loud. And then this Asian woman had the audacity to look at me like... the Dolomite in me wanted to say, bitch, are you for real? Because you the main one. But, you know, xenophobia is real. So I didn't do it. And I'm going to tell you one thing. I live in a small-ass town. I know every Asian person. We got 7 Asian people in my whole town.
You went 7? 7? Really? 7?
Seven. You didn't see the other hand because the camera. 7. All right? We got 7 of them. Ever since Rona, I've been seeing some Asians I ain't never seen before.
Yeah.
All of them. I said, who's you? I don't know you. Who's this one? I start clutching my pearls. I said, yo, that's how the xenophobia works. Because I was like, I don't know these new Asians in Burlington. These different. I know the same one.
You think that they came with the plant? Are you thinking they're the seeds? They're coming to drop the bomb in Burlington?
And I got to ask some questions because, you know, when you're from the South, everybody's Chinese. It don't matter if you're from, like, Vietnam. You know, we just got to know if you're fighting Asian or math Asian. So we got to figure out which group you fall in. We got to hit you with them questions if you're from one of them Roman countries.
The girls at work, they were dying for dim sum. Dying. And I was like, y'all, we're not eating no Chinese food. Okay?
I've been eating Chinese food, man.
No. I told the girls, I even told the Chinese people in the office, I'm not eating no Chinese, no Filipino, no Vietnamese. I ain't eating none of y'all Asian food. And y'all know my ass greedy. Don't bring nothing for me in the office to eat, okay? I'm eating shit from y'all. Keep it.
So you guys would just stick to Island Mix if you were here then, eh?
Island Mix got a little Chinese little thing in it, too.
Exactly. Oh.
I want Island. I don't want no mix. Give me roti.
All these stupid black people. I'm not getting no Chinese food. They're buying Island Mix. I'm like, the same people making it in the vacuum.
Everything's made by Mexicans in the South here. Like, you go to an Italian restaurant, you got Mexican cooks. You go to a Chinese food restaurant, Mexican cooks. You go to an African restaurant, you got some niggas and some Mexican cooks. Mexican cooks everywhere you go.
Okay. Yeah, so clearly, everybody, we're going to be talking about this Kenora virus that's going around causing
Kenora?
Drama.
Who's Kenora? Who's Kenora? Yeah, you know, I got a new shorty named Kenora, bro. She's ethnic.
She's Rona's step cousin.
That Rona, yeah, you know, my girl Kenora, you know.
Corona? I don't say the real thing. Just like, can you...
Real talk though, like 9 months from now, they're gonna have some kids named Corona because they got conceived during that virus time.
Corona baby.
A lot of people are hot and heavy, and they're at home with no toilet paper. So hey. My question is the NSA still going to commence?
Speaking of toilet paper, report?
Oh shit, light flex.
Your boy did good. You can build a castle in here.
I got some Christmas wrapping paper. It still works.
It still works. Just soak that shit in some water.
You know what I'm saying? It still works. Where I got Captain Marvel wrapping paper. It still works. They have Magic Johnson out here with a medical mask. Mm-hmm. And I'm just like, you know, I feel you, son. You ain't trying to catch all the diseases. Just because you got AIDS don't mean you ain't trying to be the Pokemon trainer of diseases. You ain't trying to catch all them shits. So yes, I don't blame him for being out here with the mask on. People mad at him. Talking about who this nigga think he is. Trying to protect himself from coronavirus. He trying to protect himself. Shit.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. AIDS ain't gonna kill him. Rona gonna kill him for sure.
Man, they got people out here with the cure for corona, because I think Trump got that shit. He went on TV talking crazy, slurring his words. He had the shaky hand. I was like, this nigga got Rona. This nigga got the Rona. Okay, you can't eat McDonald's and Diet Coke every day and not catch Rona.
Life's been kind of good since this whole Rona. The gym's empty. Gas is dirt cheap.
Yo, gas is cheap, bro. It's like zombie apocalypse price, bro.
Oh man, gas is dirt cheap. It ain't been bad. I can't lie.
Nah, bro, they changed stuff up here, man. Walmart ain't the same. Our Walmart ain't 24 hours. They got that shit stopping at 11 p.m. and they had armed security in there. Not like top flight security, like niggas with guns. I'm like, shit, that serious? Like the toilet paper shortage, is that serious that you need niggas with guns? Like they're walking around like, need help, sir? Need help, sir? I was like, do you have toilet paper? They're like, okay, they just walked out. I was like, you goddamn right. You can't help me with shit. What the hell are you doing walking around with this gun? What's a gun going to do during corona? I'm going to sneeze in your face. What's a gun going to do?
With Officer Wiggum in The Simpsons, remember we started popping shots at the virus? And he threw the gun at it?
That's the same niggas that be trying to beef with cancer. Like, I don't give a fuck, nigga. Fuck cancer. I don't care what your zodiac sign is, nigga. Oh, God, we fighting, son. Yo, fuck.
I still don't understand why we need the toilet paper. What's the hype?
Have diarrhea?
Well, the hype is, the rumor is that, you know, because toilet paper supposedly is made in China, therefore, people thought that we were going to run out of toilet paper because they weren't going to ship any because they weren't working or producing.
I heard Rona give you mud butt. And you're going to be shitting. You're going to be quarantined and shitting. My thing is, I bought paper towels. You could cut them bitches in threes and fours. It'd be a little rough, but it'll get the job done.
Should have been running out of bidets in this motherfucker, because if you're shitting that much, you need to wash your ass. So you know what? Bidets should have been shelling out, okay?
I have a solution. They should be like an ass to toilet paper ratio, because I saw the skinny heifer with like five different things of toilet paper. I'm like, you ain't got that much ass to be wiping with all that toilet paper. Now, like, if you have like a Lizzo-sized ass, your ass to toilet paper ratio is bigger, and you're going to need more toilet paper. So, respectfully, you should have more rolls because your ass to toilet paper ratio is higher.
So you're saying you should have more rolls because you have more rolls? Shit, Akil, you're a savage.
Bars, nigga! Bars! A little skinny.
So right now your house is stocked up, right, Akil?
I've been paranoid buying shit, man. Like last week, I saw people buying toilet paper, and it was some rich white people. I was like, oh shit, they about to colonize something. Let me go ahead and jump on this wave.
That's all.
Before they leave me, they trick me on another boat.
You guys going to any Costco's or anything like that and see the chaos happening?
I went to BJ's. Our BJ's is funny as hell because it's right beside the Dick's Sporting Goods. So you got Dick's and the BJ right beside each other. Also, that nigga childish. You ever designed that shit? Don't childish. Yeah. So I went in there and I'm buying juice boxes and shit. I'm buying shit that niggas ain't thinking about. I was like, you might be thirsty. You got water. But I got a juice box. Mm-hmm. See, nigga, I bought a juice box. I bought vitamin C. And I bought vitamin D, because the sun ain't been out here in this bitch for a minute.
Mm-hmm. I know every time So Sick coughs, the listeners are going to jump, like, look to the side, like, like, oh, shit.
That Rona. I don't trust
sick, bitches.
Nah, you got that Rona.
Rona.
Okay, I'm having allergies up in this motherfucker, okay? The weather is changing, okay? We're finally coming out of our 9 feet of snow. We got some grass.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what's affecting me. Okay,
you guys want to see this video of Memphis, Tennessee handling this whole corona outbreak? I'm not sure if Trisha saw this yet, so I'm gonna share it.
Yeah, let's check that out.
All right, you guys see my screen now?
Yeah.
All right, let's watch this Rona.
Don't nobody got time for that.
Why do you always find the most ignorant black people?
Exactly.
look at this.
Poor kid.
He's like, Poppy, no! Poppy, not the ice!
That's a therapy session in the making.
Oh, yeah.
This poor kid.
My hero is about to show up. Look at it. Oh. That man's trailblazer.
This guy got his hands in the jacket.
He got his whole nose out here just breathing corona. Got his whole nose out here breathing corona.
Kind of a fly color. Might be a next pick.
Yo, that's that killer can pink right there.
That's like corona pink, corona fuchsia. Yeah,
got that corona pink. Tell me what you think. Well, I don't want to see what she's talking about. What's she saying she thinks she knows? She don't know.
Oh, bullshit. Stay calm, guys.
Yeah,
nobody knows shit, y'all.
Make sure there's toilet paper for everyone.
Everything everybody's saying should start with alleged. Because nobody knows what the hell they're talking about. That's why they're quarantining our ass, because they know the shit is more serious than what's really going on, what people think, or what they're putting out there. They're afraid. They're actually afraid.
Yes, very afraid. That's why Trudeau and him are just like, his wife got it, but he's like, you know what, I'm just going to stay in so I don't get it too. Like, all these politicians are just going in just because they don't want to catch it.
Word on the street was black people can't get it. And the minute I heard that, they're like, we got a new strand. And then I heard some niggas start getting after it. I was like, oh, damn. They came up with the chicken flavored strand.
Yeah, they started
calling it chicken sandwich.
Well, if you look at the map, it shows like the whole map of Africa. Like, nobody in Africa has it.
Oh, word.
Okay.
One person in Africa was a German white man who was in Africa that had it.
They need to kick that motherfucker out.
One person in Trinidad got it from Switzerland.
Lord. Again.
Flew in from Switzerland and they flew him back out of there.
Two people in Jamaica got it from the UK.
Mm. So how you catch a wine now in Trinidad with corona? You put a mask and everything. You got a wine like this.
Yeah. Not a guy who have a wife.
You got hit them with the eyes like, again, again. Let me joke you.
People are showing videos and they're still partying in Trinidad like nothing happened.
People are partying in Toronto too. Like, there's nothing going on. Just this weekend, Moto Day from St. Lucia came up at Soccer Wave and was partying in our Toronto. Big soccer fet. And they don't care. They were
Toronto's all about that YOLO, man. They taking that Drake shit to heart. While Drake's at home probably in his basement, you know, quarantine, staying away from people. But everybody else in Toronto, YOLO baby, the six baby. You only live once, baby.
Do you know how many people told me they can't get this shit because, like, if they're black? I'm like, dog, don't listen to that shit.
My friend told me a story that she met this African girl at the grocery store that she knows. And the girl told her, she goes, Trisha, she said it to me, like, in a serious way, like, I heard that African people and black people can't get it. So don't worry about it.
So we out here treating coronavirus like lice. We treat that shit like lice, bro. I can't get that shit. I'm napping.
Exactly.
Corona can't jump on me, baby. I'm napping. It don't work that way.
Listen, our melanin is what's keeping the corona away. Okay?
Yeah, and then that one black man that got it, they're like, nah, bro, he different, though. He different.
Which black guy got it? The basketball player?
Him he and likes- the other guy, he touched up on the man's face. And then he the got man's it. Face? Yeah, he's like, good game. Good game, bro. Good game. Look, rubbed up all over
the man's face. He's like, yeah, good game, good game.
Good game, bro. Good game, bro. Good game.
I've never seen a Trinidadian basketball. Light skin move right there. What kind of shit is this?
I was like, that's why I can't trust light skin people, man. Fucking up the ecosystem.
That was wild. Canora.
All I know, all the people in Africa are sitting there going, white.
This is like oil. Oh, hey, boy, you got the Canora, dude?
You got the Canora. Warrior. I am not saying that name. It's Candyman right there. Say that shit five times. Watch what happens.
You say it five times, start calling out nowhere.
Yeah.
How y'all feel about everything getting canceled, bro? They canceled The Quiet Place. They canceled that X-Men movie for like the seventh time, New Mutants.
That's not because of this.
It's just never coming out. Mulan got canceled because the Chinese audience is not going to get to enjoy the film. Like, how y'all feel about all this stuff getting canceled? Like, school's canceled. Everything's canceled.
I'm just waiting for work to cancel. That's all I care about. I'm waiting for work to cancel and for this check to still come in while it's canceled. That's all I care about.
Yeah, they still got, like, I'm working from home with a phone, like a special VPN phone that still gets all the calls. So I'm pretty much still at work.
Damn.
It can't get away from it.
I think it's a good thing. It's the only way they could try to get an understanding of what's happening. Because if people keep going out and getting sick, that's more and more people that will be taking up the hospital. So them being like, stay in your house or stay just in a, go to work, don't go to work, go to the grocery and back, try to limit it, keeps the amount of people in the hospitals down. So I'm for it.
I'm not thinking about people stay home. I'm thinking about the people who sitting at home thinking about the scams that they can run on everybody while everybody's at home.
The scams going on right now with paper towels and toilet paper.
Okay, that's, but no, like there's going to be some new scams. Like, I think I'm going to come up with my own credit card. So that way, for people who need money,
well, a Ronna card, like
my Ronna card, my Corona card,
the Corona card.
Okay, like you get 0% interest rate at the beginning, but as soon as Corona go away in 30 days, that interest rate is gonna be 80%. Okay, for that $200 we spent. All right, I'm trying to capitalize on this shit. All right,
I think they're stealing in smart ways. Like they're going where it's really busy into stores. And they're grabbing, they have their bags, and they're just stuffing their bags of stuff. And while it's so much chaos of the cash, they're just walking out with pure steaks and random shit. I think people are already scamming it in their own different ways.
I saw a strip club advertiser like, pussy here is Corona free. Like, that's a sale. That's a sale right there. I was like, you got me now.
Yeah, my club promoter's like, yo, the park's still going to be lit tonight, though. Don't worry, you can come out.
Driving. Like, we telling people, like, it took Corona to get people to wash their hands. What disease is going to take for people to wash their ass?
None will happen. People are nasty. I'm like, who wasn't washing their hands? I washed my hands multiple times in the day. Like, how?
Well, at least Corona's getting people to wipe their ass now, at least, okay? With the toilet paper that they be stocking up on.
They're just like, fuck, I already got Rona. Let this shit air out.
Hooray, when they're bathing. Hopefully people start doing that, too. Because, you know, a lot of people do that. They're just taking the soap.
Scary, though. I feel like every, like, rich, like, those CEOs, I've been in corporate America for a while. All them rich dudes. They just be shitting and stuff, and they don't wash their hands. They come out, and they go to business meetings. And I ain't talking just like a normal, just a bloop. I'm talking like a businessman at the airport should have. And they come out, and they just, hey, how's it going today, Mr. Goddard? And they want to shake a nigga hand. That's when I'm, that's when I hit them with the elbow, or I hit them with something. They always try to shake somebody's hand after shitting down the place. They the main ones with the crew.
And then they put their hand on your elbow. How do you feel about the movies closing up and all this shit?
Our movies are still not closed yet. Like, I almost went and saw that Vin Diesel movie. My mom yelled at me. She's like, think about your kids stuff. Think about your, your selfish stuff. Yeah. You have a young child at the house now. Think about the family.
I was like, yeah, gonna go to the gym. Oh, Lord.
Oh, yeah, you can't even go to the gym. Think about your family. Yeah. I was like, all right, I'm about to just P90X or was it Insanity with Sean T yelling at my ass?
Yeah, Abra for X and shit. Oh, Lord.
Well, yeah, they only started closing down the restaurants and then the movie theaters like this week. They just announced it like an hour ago that that's what they're going to start doing in Quebec.
I feel bad for people who can't cook, who just live off like Grubhub. They mad out. They just at home mad as hell right now, waiting for that order. Just like, it's going to come one of these days. No, the hell it ain't.
Sorry, craft dinner. That's what they're having. Hot dogs and...
Listen, I feel sorry for all those people who were just eating avocado toast every day. After 2 days, the avocado's gone bad. They got nothing to eat.
I was talking to one of our cousins. And I was like, he was like, nah, man, I'm vegan now. I'm vegan. I'm done with all that. I'm like, okay. Talk to me in 2 weeks.
No, it's actually good to be vegan right now. They're selling out the meat. So like, all they have left is like veggies right now. Like, we're selling out the meat at the Walmart and at the butchers and stuff. Like, people are just like buying out everything. So I'm just like, the people I live in the South. So I live in a little ignorant ass town. So we got a ton of veggies. So it's kind of good to be vegan right now.
Nah, you got to.
We're running out of the meat.
But the thing you don't want to buy the veggies, right? You don't want to buy the fresh veggies because some nigga out there walking around confident.
Yo, saw a Chinese man. He was walking, putting his hand in the grapes. Looking at it, eating the grape pudding hand and other fruits and stuff, I was like, you're the reason why people have problems. You adding fuel to the xenophobia fire.
Nothing secure.
Just coughing and touching.
So you don't even want to pick up none of them fresh fruits. Trust.
Nothing secure.
How's the dating scene going to be out here with Corona, man?
Probably the same as it is.
Can't be going out on dates. Can't be shaking hands. I don't know you like that.
Shaking hands is the last thing they're doing. What are you talking about?
He's like, so you want me to, you know, mouth or anus? What are we doing? Nice to meet you, by the way. That's how they start a conversation.
Mouth or people anus? People are quarantining right now together. They're doing those quarantines.
I've been watching them quarantine pornos, man. They're not that good, though.
With the hazmat suits on.
Yeah, just man.
Through the zipper hole, you know?
I watched one flick. Homeboy was dicking down this girl, this white girl, and I learned a new term. When you knock it down the big, juicy white girl, you call that shit going to the trailer park. He put some weight on. He said, I'm in the trailer park now, girlina. I'm in the trailer now. I was like, oh,
shit. What kind of country you watching?
What the fuck? Who's the least to cut you off?
I was like, write that one down. Call that shit going to the trailer park. I was like, all right. So when you in there, we balls deep. You in the trailer park now, girl.
Nice.
Cooking now. Rip.
So, let's say hypothetically we do get it. What's you guys' next step?
Stay at home, play video games, and watch porn every day. So ain't shit changing, baby.
I'm going to Trinidad or Hawaii or something.
Real talk, I swear, I think I had that shit before because, like, the fall, there was some kind of, like, sickness going around. People are having, like, upper respiratory issues and they're coughing. And it wasn't the flu. And I was sick for about, like, 2 weeks. And they're just like, nigga, walk it off. So that's what I did. And then I got over it and I'm good now. And I'm like, shit, man, I think I fucked around. I had that Rona and didn't even know.
But you know what? This shit's been going on since the fall in China, right?
I tell you, I think I had it. I think I had that Rona.
Been flying.
And the only reason they brought it to everyone's attention is because they were closing down for Chinese New Year, and all the Chinese people were about to fly out all over the world and spread that shit, okay? And
does that mean I'm immune? Am I immune to it then, since I didn't have it? Might be.
Why don't you go lick a Chinese ass and find out?
on my to-do list. I'm a five. We got some new ones in the city. I'm a fine one. Excuse me, madam. You may not know me, but you know, the end is xenophobia. I will have to lick you to find out if you have that Rona.
But that's why. But yo, China, they were building walls and shit to keep each other out of their, like, boroughs.
China always building a damn wall, and the shit don't work, man.
No,
they're always trying to build some damn wall. In
China, you need a permit in China to leave your borough to go to another borough. And they set up laws and rules and regulations that if you don't follow or comply, your ass is going to jail. Meaning, they're just throwing you in a fucking ditch with a bunch of Rona people and your ass is just there. You're just done.
Niggas Rona still going to be fucking in there. It ain't going to stop it. They be like, you got Rona, I got Rona. We ain't using condoms because niggas still don't use condoms. AIDS has been around for a minute. Still ain't using condoms. Niggas still out here raw every day. No condom. So they damn sure ain't gonna start washing their hands.
Things go nope, they're not.
Usher out here with herpes, sticking his ass off. Ain't shit stopping him. He living. They need to be another celebrity, Chris Brown. Somebody need to come out and be like, yo, I got Rona. I'm living my best life. That's what it's gonna take for people to be like, it ain't so bad. Chris Brown, got it.
Listen, so I was supposed to go on vacation. I was supposed to go on to Jamaica in like 2 weeks from now. And I had to cancel that shit because when you come back, you're going to get quarantined for 14 days. Like, I had to cancel that shit, okay? And I was just like, you know how, you know, when you actually paid for your vacation, you're actually ready to go. And it's like, yo, I can't go. Not because I'm broke and I can't go. It's just that I can't go because of fucking corona. My ass is vexed.
Man, I've been booking shit for the future. And I'm like, I'm going to cancel that shit later if I need to, like, maybe I might go to Mexico in August. Maybe I might do this shit in December. Fuck it. Get it while I can, nigga. Fuck Jeez. All that. Yeah. Nigga, I'm trying to live in tomorrow. I ain't trying to live in the now. The now is depressing. I'm trying to think about my future, nigga. My future's in Jamaica or some shit in August. Hopefully that shit clear out by then. Fuck it. Hopefully.
So you guys think Trump has it or not?
That nigga been acting crazy. And the thing is, to be up at 3 a.m. and just typing and shit and not to be an alcoholic, something ain't right. Like, if you drunk and you typing shit at 3 a.m., I understand, like, you tipsy, you wild. But if you sober and you doing that, something ain't right.
But the corona is hitting his demographic, right? It's his, like, you know. It's
killing his voters, the older white people, 60.
Yeah, so... Exactly. So he's like 70, how old now? 74, something like that, 75. So he definitely got it from that Brazilian man. He was the first person that got in that room.
Let me tell you something about Trump.
And he got it.
Let me tell you something about Trump. Why this man don't give a shit. This is the same man who said he ain't afraid to grab some pussy. This is the same man that dicked down the porn star raw. No condom, raw. Raw dog.
And so you think it like he was in the
So you think this man's afraid of corona after he's been in the stripper raw?
Yeah, nah. Raw. He's like, I'm rich,
like,
bitch.
He's like, you don't know the shit I done did in the 70s. Smell these damn hands, boy. Like, what do you think I've been up to?
Oh, he thinks he's fine because he's like, I'm white and rich. I'm immune to this shit.
Nigga, this is the same nigga who's attracted to it. Think he's afraid of Rona? He gonna just add Ronda to the roster. He like, could I touch her pussy too?
This is okay to viruses. Like, you know the whole boomer thing? This is the all right boomer of that.
No, this
shit.
Is the boomer doomer. This shit killing them boomers. This shit taking out boomers.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I'm telling you, they're gonna come out with a black strain. Shit gonna be, they're gonna attach it to some collard greens and chicken.
Yeah, that's COVID-19, man. That's a newer name.
Trish over here dying in the corner over there.
Every
time she's like,
that's a damn
God damn.
Oh, thank God we on Skype right now.
I know. Shit.
I'm real nervous.
I tell you, I'm
direct. This is how good looks. You don't even know if you can catch it. Look how good this bitch looks. You don't even know she got Rona.
Where my lights all at? For the Rona. I was thinking they said like 1 out of 6 people have herpes. I'd be thinking like how many guests we had on this podcast that may have had herpes.
Oh my God.
1 out of 6.
I always hear the ratio changes. 1 out of 3, 1 out of 4.
It might be 1 out of 3, man. I tell you, man, they ain't using condoms out here, but they tried to tell people to wash their hands when they ain't even washing their ass. Whole ass dirty and crusty. trying to get somebody to eat it. And they ain't trying to wash their hands. There was a rich dude, he went on Fox News, happy as hell, talking about, I don't wash my hands. He made it sound like that's some poor people shit. He's like, wash hands! Nigga, not me!
Yeah, I don't know. This corona shit's crazy, though. Is there anything else that you guys want to talk about with corona, or do you want to end it here? Any more videos you want to add?
Shit, I'm not sure if I got any more corona videos. whenever you're ready, we could talk about that Candyman.
Okay, cool. What time are we on? Because I'm not recording. I'm not writing down notes. I'm blind right now. I don't see what's going on.
Oh, this is an off the dome drunk episode. Brought to you
what
by
time on the record. What time are we at?
What time are we at? Where's it say that shit out? Oh, 46.
Okay, cool.
All right. You want to get into this Candyman review? I haven't seen that shit. So since everything's closed, all the theaters are closed and stuff.
Yeah.
I decided, you know, me and Casey were talking about, you know, Candyman and how good that movie is and how he's like the original gangsta of a black horror icon. So
yeah.
Go ahead and talk about that. Trisha, you want to watch the trailer with us?
Yeah, go ahead.
Candyman was a smooth nigga, man. He always had the fur coat on. He had that hook. He would hide the hook. He wouldn't show the hook at first. He'll tease that shit.
You ever heard of Candyman?
He loves some white women, boy.
He must be Jamaican.
He's like, I don't want that curly haired sister right there.
I know.
That white woman, though.
He stepped over a gem. I was like, what's this guy doing?
He's like, I got you, bitch.
Yeah.
That's modern oral folklore.
You know how in those movies in the 90s, everybody was smoking cigarettes. They'd go to restaurants, blowing smoke in kids' faces.
Yeah.
They're like, fuck these kids.
They still have the style, though. Like, the way they're all dressed. She looks the same as she does now.
No, black,
that black
crack.
Woman?
Black don't crack unless you smoke it.
Yeah, man.
My boy, look at my boy right there. He's like, yeah, man.
And pulled up on her.
Got the coat. Got the furs.
Hey, you're going to have a bad man when you see one, eh?
You see Miguel? You see the coat? It's a bad man.
Put her through hell. Love it.
Yo, when he flew
like, out the... You want the black doggy? That's what you just get when you take the black doggy, yeah.
Candyman should have been West Indian, man.
I'm sure Candyman is Jamaican.
The way he chased white women.
Only thing sweet about Candyman is his name. Oh yeah. So yeah, the trailer came out for this movie for the 2020 version that's supposed to be coming out 2022 now. And because of that, this is one of my favorite old school horror movies. So I thought we'd rewatch it and do a retro review of this thing and talk about it. And you know, get our thoughts on it and make people go see it and download it or rent it and check it out, because this is actually still, to me, it still holds up as a good movie. It touched on some
Casey,
things that were...
When this movie came out, y'all weren't even allowed to stay up past 8 o'clock. So y'all never watched this movie when it came out in 1990.
I did, okay? Because my parents bought it and they were supposed to rewind it before they returned it.
Casey watched it probably with Clint.
Probably.
I watched the copy I was supposed to rewind, and I forgot to rewind it. I was like, I'm gonna watch this shit, and I saw him gut this man from his booty hole, and that shit just scared me. We're gonna talk about that scene later.
With
that
the
shit just
rusty
that shit messed
hook.
Me up. With a rusty hook, he gutted the man from his booty hole.
Yeah, this movie still holds up. This, like, it flirted with a couple of things. Being older, watching this, like, I noticed that it did talk about like all the crimes that's happening in Chicago, and once one white woman goes in there and says, this happened to me, then the cops go in there and actually do cop work. But they're letting people run amok. They kind of flirted with that whole concept of that. The cinematography in this was pretty good. I like the lighting they used over her eyes when they were telling the stories, and everything went dark except for over her eyes. That was pretty dope in the restaurant. It had some cool little tricks they used in this movie. And the issue...
Casey, now I think about it, when this movie came out, I think I used to scare you in the mirror. I think I used to be like, Casey, come here. I think we scared you for like a week, Clint. I swear to God. But like, Casey, say Candyman. Say Candyman in the mirror. And then we'd run and turn off the lights and shit on you. I swear to God we did that to you.
You see, I still don't say his name.
Yes, sir. Yeah, man. This movie's great, though. Do you remember the movie at all, Trisha?
I do remember the movie. I just remember, like, him just being a big black nigga. And
what?
That's all I remember. I just remember him being a
Were we talking about the Blind Side, or are we talking about Candyman? That sounds like the Blind Side to me. A big black nigga.
No, but like when you're young, I didn't rewatch it like you guys, but when you're young watching that, he's just like this older black man in the friggin' like mirror coming to get you. And so my whole thing growing up was like we were just afraid to say Candyman in the mirror, you know? That was like a thing for like 6 months, you know, daring people at school, making people say it, you know? That was the thing.
I think it was Bloody Mary you guys were messing with me with, if I remember right.
Everybody tells the same Bloody Mary story. Oh, somebody went in, they said it three times, they nose started beer bleeding.
I remember.
Or a girl said it and she went on her period.
I remember being Candyman.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think we were still living in Brampton at the time. And I remember being Candyman. And I was like, I remember us going in the mirror and doing that stupidness, like, Candyman, Candyman. Like, we're doing it, okay? You see, I will never say it the third time, y'all.
It's five times. You gotta say five.
I don't care. I don't go past three, okay? And we're like, trying to scare each other. I just remember doing that.
So let me give some backstory on this real quick on Candyman. So this was a story written by Clive Barker. He does a lot of scary films. This was part of an anthology that he written called The Forbidden. Now, I got a theory. Clive Barker is British and very gay. So my thing is, he said that it came to him in a dream. I think he was having a sexual dream. He was thinking about a sweet man with that hook. You see what I'm saying? With that hook penis. You see what I'm saying? The hook. And then he woke up and he's like, oh, this is a nigga with a big old hook. Let me turn this into a nightmare. He turned that hook penis into a hook hand. All right. Now, when he first wrote Candyman, it wasn't a black guy. It was just a person with a hook when they in the story. But when they hired the actor, Tony Todd, he was able to write the backstory. He's the one that came up with the whole backstory of him being a slave. He was free. He was a free man, and he was a painter, and he got this white woman pregnant, and they mutilated him. They cut off his hand. They put a hook there, and then they put a bunch of honey on his chest, and as he was getting stung to death, they're calling him Candyman, and then they burnt him alive, then took his body apart and, like, discarded the body parts everywhere. So he got a vendetta against white people. But he ain't afraid to kill a nigga or two. He'll do it.
Or a kid.
Or kid.
Or kid.
Who's going off this?
I think that's why it was scary, because he killed everybody. Nobody was safe.
Nobody. And he liked that shit. He was like, yo, I got to keep my name going. Y'all can't make me look soft out here. Oh, yeah, she's like, he was like, you making me look soft, so I got to make sure I get you the best. I was like, oh, shit, Candyman's for real. The only thing that I was like laughing at that pissed me off was she was being the main character. She was being so nice to everybody in the hood and all this stuff, but she still had her gloves on the whole time. She never took her gloves off. Like, she'd be touching people when she had the gloves on. Like,
she didn't want to catch the Rona. She knew about the Rona from back then. She didn't want to catch it.
Yeah. I was like, that's some bullshit. Take the damn gloves off. Relax. You'll be fine.
Yeah, they really show you, like, the gentrification that's about to happen in Chicago. And I ain't gonna lie, man. That place is scary as fuck. It needs some gentrification, man. It's scary as hell in them streets, boy.
The graffiti tripped me out when I was little. When I saw when she was climbing through the holes, and then it showed her climbing through, and it was actually a drawing of Candyman's mouth open wide as he's going through pain, and she's climbing out the mouth. I was like, holy shit! I remember when I saw that back little. That tripped me out. I saw that now. And I was like, oh,
that's a metaphor, man. He tried to swallow that white woman.
Swallow her soul.
He's like, I want all that white woman in my mouth.
All that.
I want all of it.
Nasty.
what was I about to say? Go ahead, Casey. I'm sorry. What were you saying?
Yeah, that was my only critique problem with this movie after being older and watching it. I was like, this guy is such a sucker for white girl love. Like, I was like, what is
going on? Oh, yeah, he sure is. He don't give a damn.
Crawled in the hole to go be with her to get bun up, and then she ends up leaving the hole, and he's like, wait, no!
No, not my white woman, no!
Yeah, like, this is stupid. That got a low rating for me from that part right there. I was like, what are you doing right there? Sorry,
it's
go
like
ahead.
It's like they gave Tiger Woods supernatural powers. Yeah. He's like, I'm going to save every basic white woman.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I liked how Candyman would like frame them, how he'll set them up where it looks like they did it, so he keeps that legend going. Because it reminded me of the Invisible Man movie that just came out. It had the same kind of premise where you don't know if the person's crazy or not. And I'm like, oh, shit, they borrowed a lot from Candyman. Tony Todd's performance as Candyman's done very well. He's intimidating. He doesn't even talk a lot. Like, when he first appears, like, you don't really see his mouth move. But he's talking. He's having that monologue. And sitting in his mind, he's like, yeah, bitch. He's like, you're mine now. You see this coat? You see these furs? You see this hook?
When he was in the parking lot standing up and he had that whole swag in his stand, I thought he was on the runway. I thought he started walking up to her.
Man,
I had to chuckle a little. That was not as scary as when I was little.
Man, that shit was fly when he showed up. He's like, yeah, it's your boy.
Coat it's touching the flow. Yeah. It's a good movie, though. It was good. I still enjoyed it to watch it now. It was still very enjoyable.
Well, the story's kind of like, first of all, this woman's just writing a thesis about graffiti. And then she's so nosy and so fast with herself that she gets caught up in this whole mythos of Candyman. And starts stalking and like harassing all these local black people about the story of Candyman to the point where she meets local gang members who dress up like Candyman. They whoop her ass.
Yeah, man.
And here's what happens, Trisha. This man dresses up like Candyman. He has a hook. Instead of hooking her, he takes the blunt end of the hook and he butts her in the eye with it. It says, I'm Candyman, bitch. And he hits her in the eye with it. Now, I got a scene of the guys on the runway where they're she's trying to find out which one's the one that butt her in the eye.
Oh yeah. She could have been wrong. They just tried anybody. Put the sound on. Can't hear.
Oh, sorry, do it again.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah, this scene was the lineup of the police station. She had to use the voices of each person that they caught and off their voice decide who's guilty and who they're gonna charge and arrest. When I saw that, I was like, yo, this is such a loose way to catch a person. This is all they're using and going off to put somebody in jail.
You're like, yeah, I think it's that black guy. All right, let's go ahead and catch
him. You're ready to arrest anybody and put them in jail for life. Holy. Yeah, I can't hear it still.
You still you can't? What the hell? Well, this guy said, I'm the Candyman, bitch.
There we go. Yeah, it's really low.
Is it?
I'm Candyman, bitch.
There you go. Let's see what this is about. That nigga look like he did. He like Luther Vandross. Woo, look at that eye.
Look at her eye.
Oh, you're too fast at yourself.
Too fast.
Too fast. And then the other scene that's one of my favorite scenes is when Candyman first appears with that swag. Swag on the million. Look at her being fast. She's like, whew. She's like, oh, I got all this Negro material I'm going to show the world. There's no sound right. She's just like, whew.
And guess what? She's wearing gloves.
Steal all their culture. Look at my man's shoes.
He's off the runway with it.
Whew. Candyman got to be the cleanest villain.
Talking about. But yeah, she's wearing gloves.
Whew. Look at the shoes. Look at the fur.
A nice leather.
He's like that's that post Civil War fur, bitch. What you know about that?
Yeah, she don't even know what's about to come. Got the Ray-Bans on in the dark.
Girl, I'm about to put that hook on you. That low hook in my pants.
Christian, do you remember any of this scene at all? Look at this guy's swag.
Dripping. Look at the Candyman drip.
You see his head? His head is up in the air like that. That's amazing. Y'all.
He's like real niggas got Adam's apple. Look at this shit, girl. He hit her with it, but he's like, you feel that? Her ovaries were hurting. That's why she fell. He's like, you're quivering, girl. Look at this. He ain't been in the presence of a god.
We hear it. Just
you feel that pipe, girl? You feel that pipe in your mouth?
Yeah, exactly.
It's like you're mesmerized. You ain't never seen a real one like this. Look at it walk up on her slow.
he's off the runway with it.
Yo, Candyman drip game so hard.
It was.
He's like, I ain't even gonna show you the hook. She's like, oh my god, black man, what you gonna do to me? What you won't. What you won't. Whatever you want, girl. Call me Candyman because I'm sweet. Make you cry. He ain't even moving his lips. He's like, yeah, bitch, I'm talking to you in your mind. Look at that rusty, dusty hook that man got.
I know, but why they gotta make the skin around, like the flesh looking like it's still raw? Like,
it is raw, man. That's the life he live. He raw out here. Candyman, he's some condoms. He's like, yeah, girl, infinite supply of honey, girl. I'm sweet.
Even the scene when he makes out with her and he has all the bees flying out of his mouth and all the bees falling into her mouth. Woo, creepy shit.
Candyman's a sweet man. So here's my problem with Candyman. There's a mentally challenged kid that went and said his name 5 times. Candyman showed up and cut his dick off and let him bled to death. Like, that shit reminded me of Boosie when he was talking about Dwayne Wade's son. Why you cut his dick off, man?
Not his dick, man. Come on, bro.
I was like, Boosie, man. I was like, they done Candyman, that little boy. Candyman's ruthless. And that's how Clive Barker makes his characters. He makes them with no moral compass. He's gonna kill a baby, a kid, a woman, a child. There ain't no right or wrong. It's if you in the way, I'm a gutcha. And he got that rusty, dusty ass hook. It's not even gonna be a smooth kill. Cause the scene where he guts that man from the booty hole, it's such a it's like he's struggling. He's like, you hear it like ripping the man booty hole from his booty hole to the back of his throat.
And what's great about that scene too is they have the whole scenic like movie music playing, and they cut anytime you kill somebody, they cut the music, and you just hear the and like the fucking hook just going through the person. Like, it's so like realistic. Like, they stop all theatrics and they just let the realistic look and sound effects play through.
From the killing play through. Terrifying.
Yeah,
so they try to instill fear in your minds about this is what a nigga's gonna sound like when he's killing your white bitches. Right, bitch.
Let me hear you. Let me show y'all the booty hole gutting. That shit scared me. I wasn't ready for all this. I wasn't ready for all this booty hole gutting that Candyman did.
It got you.
Watch this right here. She's looking in the mirror. She's like, I'm gonna call his black ass right now.
Yeah, it's Candyman. Like, okay. Let's call the ops real quick.
Candyman just pop up out of nowhere. Can y'all hear the shit?
It's very low.
I think the recording for this is low, but you just gotta see. Look, gutting that booty hole. He's like, ah, your ancestors killed the nigga, and I'm back.
Space, you remember that?
He's like ripping the ass.
Just looking at him. I like that, eh?
He's like, bitch, this is my reparations right here.
What on his forehead and everything.
He's like, you like that, don't you?
And he just dashes the hair like Batman.
How you explain that, like, an officer comes in the room like, damn, this skinny white woman gutted this man booty hole.
And strong as hell.
No way. This woman's probably about 110 pounds. If gutted that man from his booty hole. Look how he flies out backwards.
he just fly out the window.
That backwards.
That had to be the smoothest. He's like, watch a nigga fly off.
Just bust through backwards. I never seen
that. Candyman had to be the like Freddie would hit you with the jokes, but Candyman would hit you with the smoothness. He didn't have time to joke. He's like, yo, I'm here to kill. I'm going to get it done. I'm going to fly out smooth.
Candyman and fucking Freddy Krueger are my top two of all time, man. Those two, my niggas, man. Shit.
Now, the way Candyman dies is he's basically lynched and burned to death. And then in the film, they got like this homeless ass kid throughout the film. Like, he's just living in like the streets, raised him. Dirty ass Michael Jackson looking nigga on the streets. He's just like, oh, there's a Candyman's out here in the street. He's talking like a slave.
He's 5 years old. 5-year-old body.
I was like, where are your parents at? We gonna get in a heap of trouble if he gets
5-year-old man in a 5-year-old body.
It's just but like a random scene. Like,
didn't they make a Candyman 2?
Them shits don't count. They made no sense. Like, he just showed up in New Orleans. He's like, I'm here to party. I'm like, what? What?
Had him in Mardi Gras shit. It was just in shit.
What are
you doing? Chicago to fucking New Orleans.
Here's the scene that tripped me out in Candyman, Casey. So when the white lady, she's on the run and she's trying to, you know, like clear herself, and she's walking around the streets of Chicago with a hook, crazy bitch. Yeah. So when she's walking through the pile of trash, that homeless kid, he just wakes up one day, he's like, "We gotta burn this motherfucker down." Like, he just ran, like, he ran to the earth. He's like, "We gotta burn everything down. We gotta burn all this down." Like, how do you know she was in there with the baby, and why did he feel the urge to burn everything down? He had the whole hood burning it down with him.
Yeah. They all believe. That's what? Why. Just like how So Sick said it 5 times. They all believe. They all believe. So he was like, "Oh shit, he's in there. We gotta burn him now." And hey, kid was right, man. He saw the shit moving. He didn't know. Right.
I'm just like, cell phones didn't exist, so he had to walk around telling people. Yeah,
exactly. Man was lying down in his bed. He's just like, "What the hell was that noise?" And he looked up. He's like, "Okay, it's go time. Wake up."
He got the nigga senses. He's like, what was that? Time to get up.
That was kind of a dope concept with the kids.
In the new film, like that homeless kid needs to show back up.
Hey man, you know what? I think he's gonna be in the next movie, the new one coming out. Just like
because the little baby is the main character in the new movie.
Yep.
So maybe the homeless kid's gonna show up and be like, "I've been out here living in these streets like a rat for the past 20 years."
He's catching the first gutting.
Oh god, that booty hole gut. How you top that?
That's how this movie's great, man. Jason can't fuck with this shit. This shit was great.
And the way he would frame that lady woke up in the tub with blood and killed the dog. Like, I don't understand why Candyman kills the people he kills. There'll be a one white woman that says his name, but he'll kill all the niggas around her and leave her alive. Like, "I'm gonna kill all your black friends." "I'm gonna kill all your black friends, but I'm gonna leave you to suffer." I don't understand that.
Man is a smooth criminal. I felt bad when he killed the black girl, though, man. He didn't have to do that.
Yeah, so, like, if I go to a party and there's some white people in the bathroom saying Candyman, he gonna show up and say, "Surprise, nigga," and kill me? Nah, yes. Not being in the bathroom saying that stupid shit.
He killed everybody. No witnesses.
Yeah, like, you can't even be the vicinity of somebody doing that shit, or he gonna kill you.
But for 1992, that movie was pretty smart for its time, using like the psychological aspect of, is she crazy or is it really happening? Making you question that the whole time during the movie. The only time when it actually is like, "Oh shit, she's not crazy," is when the therapist gets murdered. But before that, it's like, is she actually doing this? It made me question if she's actually doing it.
Well, listen, that's the premise that they got to use on all these white women nowadays, cop calling people for no reason. They're like, "Is this bitch crazy?
She got that Candyman. She got that Candyman in her system."
Exactly.
Yeah. I didn't like in the beginning where they first showed them. I think they should have kept the mystery where they show you like Sam Raimi's brother, and the girl's like, "Oh, I was on a date," and she said it, and he showed up behind. He's like, "Ah, bitch, I got the hook." They could have kept that out. They could have kept the whole mythos going.
They should have showed how he got murdered, like not in like a full like story, but just like someone telling the story, and then you just see like snippet shots of like the racist white guys holding him down and sawing, then a snippet shot of him sawing his hand off. You know, quick little shots of his story.
That would have been more impactful than him be like, "Surprise, bitch, I got hooked."
Exactly. Him just being behind the guy like, "Ah." It's like, "All right, well, we know what you got. This is all you are." So, but they ended up keeping it interesting to me. For an old school movie like this, I think it still holds up. I was surprised.
In this generation, they're going to be some lonely bitches calling Candyman, talking about, "I heard you got that hook, nigga." He's like, "I'm here to kill." She's like, "You gonna kill her, right?" She opened them legs. He's like, "That's not the type of work I do." She's like, "But I'm white." He's like, "All right, well, you're a white woman, so I guess I can."
Let me let my internet load up. Hold on a second. You know what I mean? So I'm interested what they're gonna do with the new movie and how they're gonna use gentrification, because the whole that whole hood is like blown down and they put condos and like nice little houses and shit now. So I guess all the older people are going to know about Candyman still. The new guy's going to be the baby. Like how it is a pretty interesting story they have to go off of. But is the white woman still alive?
Because she died. She died at the end. She became her own Candyman. She was the Helen. You say
that
Helen
was whack. 5 times. That was whack at the end, though.
Dusty white woman show up like, oh, I'm here to coupon. Bitch was there to collect coupons and stress niggas out.
Why he would yell Helen at the glass like that, though? Like
exactly. Like, Helen. That's right up there with Batman's Superman saying Martha. That's a dumb shit.
Yeah, that was one real corny part to me. I was like, they could have ended the movie. Let him die. Let her just come and kill him. You know what I mean? She doesn't have to be the Candyman, say it 5 times type of thing still. But I still enjoy it.
That's like you saying Karen 5 times in the mirror and like a white woman named Karen shows up. She's like, I'm here to coupon. Here's a potato salad with sweet, with potatoes and with green beans and all types of bullshit in there that you don't even want.
I want to see your man. Raisins in it.
Raisins. He got green beans and raisins in there. Corn. Just say,
your manager.
Where's your manager? You're like, oh.
Take me to your manager. You're like, oh, shit.
Karen with the Karen cut where they have that swoop. And she got a mixed kid named Jaden. Also got a mixed kid named Jaden somewhere.
How do you feel? Did you feel like what we're saying makes you interested to want to go see the movie again? Or you're like, nah. Sounds like
no. I really like Candyman.
No, I was literally afraid of Candyman as a preteen. So for me, watching it now, however they're gonna remake it, it probably won't be as scary. It's not gonna be as impactful.
Okay.
So I really don't have no interest really in seeing it again.
I'm interested. I want to see what they do with the gentrification. They have it basically where the little boy is being possessed by Candyman because he took a liking to that kid for no reason. He's like, take this little nigga with me for no reason. Like, come here, little nigga, baby. If I die, you die.
He really did take that baby for no reason.
Candyman's kind of on some Uncle Ruckus shit. He's like killing his own people for no reason. He bends over backwards for white women. I don't know, some self-hate going on with Candyman.
some Sambo shit.
Candyman might bleach his skin in the next movie. They might catch him rubbing some bleach.
Can you come in looking like Vibes Cartel? Come on, looking like Vibes.
Call me Duffy from now on. Duffy man. Duffy man.
What's that? The bleaching cream those Jamaicans put on? I forgot the name of that shit. But that's what Candyman's gonna have. He's gonna have that bleaching cream.
Covered with some tight Versace jeans and some pointy shoes.
The new Candyman's gonna be Safari Stretch. Candyman needs to either be Boosie Badass or Safari.
Yeah.
Boosie is a hilarious Candyman.
If you guys saw the preview, who was playing Candyman? They didn't show?
Yeah, Tony Todd is back. Yeah, the original Candyman's back, but he's possessing a new person and trying to make that person become Candyman.
Yeah.
But the original Candyman looked like he was already 50 in the original movie. Like,
CG, baby. You could, Marvel de-ages people. You could de-age that nigga.
What I think they're going to be doing is using his voice, but they're going to be using 3D, like, reflections off the glass or mirrors and, like, little shots like that, like, in 3D. I don't think they're actually going to show the actual actor's face.
They are going to show it because Jordan Peele said there's going to be, like, a dope reveal. I think they're going to save it for the end, and it's probably going to be CG. Because you can't blow the budget having him, young the whole movie.
Oh, Jordan Peele is doing it.
They're probably going to save it for one scene.
Yes, you are. So I'm saying, I know you're not going to watch the original, but yeah, the new one, I'm sure a lot of people are interested.
Okay, you know what? Because honestly, because I like Jordan Peele's movie, so the fact that he's doing it, I am going to watch it because he's really going to make it interesting.
Jordan Peele
can
relate.
He's not going to fail the culture.
Jordan Peele loves white women just like Candyman, so he can relate. he's like, shit, Candyman spitting that shit. I don't blame him. I will walk through the fires for that woman. Candyman risked everything. He risked his whole legend, his reputation, everything for that woman. He's like, shit, I'm gonna make your mind. For no reason.
Nathan Stewart Jarrett is playing Troy Cartwright, and he might be the next Candyman. We're thinking. He was in Watchmen as Dr. Manhattan. He was in Aquaman as Black Manta.
Yeah, that guy. Yeah.
If you could put a face on him from what I'm saying or not, but that might be the next candy.
I'm going to pull him up for Trisha real quick.
Yeah.
His name is like Yahya Abdul Mateen the second.
Yeah.
I don't know who's Nathan Stewart. No, you gave the wrong name.
Oh, my bad.
It's the Yahya guy, Yahya Abdul Mateen.
Mateen the second.
All right, let me show Trisha real quick. This is the new Candyman. He look like he be killing white women.
Yeah, he does.
He's like, come here, girl. He's like, I'm going to kill that one right there.
Do you know why I thought it was Nathan? Because the other woman and him have the same last actor name, like character.
Okay, yeah, I know who he is. Yeah, look at that face. That nigga Blake.
He's like, yeah, that's him.
White okay, woman. I remember him from that. I remember him from that movie. All
right. So yeah, he's tall and he's a good actor. So
yeah.
Shit, he was great. No, he was the best thing in that Baywatch movie.
I thought who would have been good too. What's his name? I don't even know his name, but it's like some weird name, Mamabu dude or something like that. He did that game movie. That game.
Moon Knight.
Moonlight. Him.
Moonlight. Yeah.
Yeah, he would be good too. I always thought that guy should play 50 Cent in a movie. Like if 50 Cent had a movie and he's on about 50 Cent, he could play 50.
Yo, homeboy was born to play Candyman ever since the Get Down. Look at that fur.
Yeah.
He
was ready. He's like, I get to wear fur and the hook? Say no more.
Yeah, so the theory right now is that Candyman's going to be the new Candyman, basically.
By the end of the film.
Yeah, and they're gonna make up Candyman 2 and mess it all up again.
He'll go to New Orleans and party.
Go be Toronto Carabana.
It's 8-hour drive from Chicago. Yeah, you could get here.
Picture the Candyman legend in Trinidad. They'd be like, the man with the hook who like to juke people. You like Moco Jumpy? No, Candyman.
The sweet man, Jumpy.
Yeah, that's Candy, man. All right, yeah. I think that's it for us. Y'all, you have anything else you guys want to talk about?
Nah, man, I'm good. So
wear your mask, wear your gloves, wrap it up. See, protect yourself against the Rona, bitches.
Nah. I'm looking forward to all these December babies, man. I'm going to be holding it down.
Listen, I wonder what people's playlists are like right now for this Rona Nights. These Rona Nights, they're calling it.
The Isley Brothers, Contagious. What else are they going to be playing?
Toxic, Britney Spears.
Yep.
There's a whole playlist.
Getting it in.
Before we leave, I got to share this with y'all, man. This is how it's looking out here in these streets, man. People fighting over that damn toilet paper.
I still don't get it. Take a shower.
And they ain't buying soap, but they buying hand sanitizer.
They're not buying soap. They're not buying vitamins. They're not buying anything that can heal their gut and their keep themselves healthy, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Some chlorophyll and shit, you know?
Sanitizer kills bacteria, not viruses, so it's kind of pointless, but...
Right. They out here buying sanitizer. Just go buy some bottle of 100 proof rum and pour in your hands. Kill it.
What they're doing is the equivalent of buying mouthwash but not brushing their teeth with toothpaste. Like, I'm gonna just use this mouthwash. I ain't gonna brush my teeth.
Yeah,
halitosis bread.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, it's alarming how backwards the society is and how unprepared we are for shit like this.
Yo, this is like, you know. In population control, survival of the fullest, like the dumbest people getting killed off.
2020, I literally said 2020 is like the Hunger Games. Every month is a new fucking thing for you to battle. And if I see you in 2021, bitch, you lucky you made it.
Catch yourself. Yo, I remember in Canada, like there was like a bad ice storm, and they gave us like a certificate for surviving that shit. Yeah, I want a trophy for coronavirus. I want a silver trophy that's like a silver hand sanitizer bottle with a piece of toilet paper on the back. Let niggas know I survived this shit.
There's rumors that they might cancel Caravana, and everybody's saying that they're still just go downtown and party anyways. Like, yeah, they try to cancel Caravana, 100,000 people are still going to go downtown. It's like, oh, shit.
We'll see. Well, out of the hundreds of thousands of people that went to Trinidad, only one person have it. Listen, it's true what they say. The rum, this kill, Rona.
You drink some punchin' and you're good.
You drink some punchin', you know, you're good. People, doubles and the plenty pepper kill the Rona.
Okay? The pepper sauce kills the Rona, eh?
For all my gamers out there, like, they got a lot of games cheap right now. You can play that Call of Duty Warzone for free. They got Division for like $2. These game companies, they know what's up. They know people are at home, so they put all these games on sale. So I tell people, you know, just game, stay at home, cook your own food. Cook your own food.
If you're in the theme for wanting to watch virus shows and movies, The Simpsons Season 4, Episode 21 is the one where they talk about the virus and they have all that joke stuff. Has 12 Monkeys, go watch that. And Contagion, I think it's called, is on all streaming services. So go check that out too.
They got Pandemic on Netflix.
Watch Supernatural End of Days, man. Watch Supernatural End of Days. Dean talked about saving stockpiling on toilet paper. I think that's where everybody got it from. Because when they ran out of toilet paper at the end of days in Supernatural, he was just like, yo, remember that.
All right, Trisha, Casey, we're at the 1:06 mark. I think we're good now. All right, Trisha, let people know where you at, where they can hit you up, what we got going on.
You can hit me up at SoSick12 on Instagram, and that's about it, bitches.
All right. Thank you so much for being on again.
Thank you, guys. It's been almost a year I haven't been on this shit.
No.
You know you're always welcome, right?
No, nah, you're not. You're welcome sometimes.
99% of the time I'm welcome.
I'm like Candyman. Where the white women at?
No, sometimes I want to do it, but then Bronson's in the background running around talking, screaming, so I can't do it.
That'll add to the show, man. That keeps the energy.
All right.
Casey, you got anything going on? You want people to hit you up on PlayStation?
I'm trying to play that Division 2. That's what I'm trying to do right now, since I got so much time on my hands.
I've been playing Super Mario Maker again, too.
That's a great game. It's a classic, man.
Can't go wrong. All right, y'all. This is the Bacchanal Podcast. Hopefully, we'll be back. Hopefully, we survive the coronavirus.
We'll be back. And no, I don't got that shit, y'all. I have allergies, okay?
Trisha got it, man. I don't trust light-skinned women.
Pray for so sick.
Look, her camera froze. That's why, because she lying on line.
Anyways,
out here lying on Al Gore's internet. lying out. That's why I froze on you, like, she lying. Let's capture this lie face. Lying.
Ain't lying, okay? Stop it.
She has a mouth full of Rona. Out here talking.
Throat full of Ronas.
Itching just thinking about it. All right, y'all, that's it for the Bacchanal Podcast.
I ain't gonna lie, y'all. I just interviewed a whole bunch of people a few weeks ago because I was looking for a new person on my team, and I interviewed pure chatty people. So who knows?
Oh, Lord. Xenophobia brought to you by the Bacchanal
Podcast. Yeah, that's 4 or 5 hours away from me. And you came
to leaving on this.
What? You were 2 weeks ago. What the hell?
I'm done recording on this note. Peace.
All right. Peace.